You are now watching movies taken from the Coronado Modelers in their formative days with Don Mitchell, my grandson Jamie, and my granddog Doris and Don Mitchell, taken back at Williamstown, Leo Beauchamp, Roy Kenville, Cessna Skyler, being phoned by Bob Corner, Walter Osichuk with Doris and Jackie in the background, and the further flying. These were taken at Rhinebeck, New York in the early 70s. That's Roy Kenville walking back from a good flight, and Leo Beauchamp. Bob Corner, from one of our original members who moved on to Belleville, Jackie again. Dawn and Doris fooling around. The Cessna Skyline again. Leo Beauchamp. And this is a group of people that were taken back out at Williamstown. Remember, hand launching with Norma Lynn. You're looking at Walter Osichuk's back. Don Mitchell. Remember, these guys were in their 30s then, and they're all in their 60s and 70s, or dead. A lot of the flying in the early days of the Coronado Modelers was performed by a single channel. Most of our club members, as a matter of fact, all of our club members flew only with single channel. With the Galloping Ghost and Mighty Midget, propulsion systems like that that would drive your, instead of the servos that we have now. So we really learned the hard way coming up. When you bought a radio, you normally got the transmitter and the receiver and nothing else. No on-off switch, no servos. You had to get them yourself. So we did a lot of this kind of basics ourselves, and we learned along the way on how to really put everything together in order to be able to complete a decent RC flight. And what you're looking at right now is the Rhinebeck, New York, that was taken because of our strong interest in the early 70s, 71, 72, 73. We went to Rhinebeck, New York because we were invited, anybody that had a World War I type aircraft, to bring it on and display it. And this is why we, with our interest in World War I and every other kind of airplane, we went to Rhinebeck, New York, and watched the full-scale airplanes fly. Further on, after we've... this was taken in Messina, New York, at the Model Airs Field. Don Mitchell flying at Grays Creek. Don Mitchell again. My little grandson, Jamie, taking a Upper Canada Village right in front of the memorial. These are our pictures of my little grandson and the plane that was kind of got hammered and he was replying. That was Tom Silver, I think. That's Guy LaPointe, Roger LaPointe, and Jeanette LaPointe. Roger was a long-term member of our club. Cliff again, flying some kind of a biplane. And this was taken at Grays Creek in the right after the formation of the field, when we finally got it in the asphalt lead. And anyways, those were the good old days in the early 80s. This was a dog again. All wherever I went, the dog came. What you're viewing now are scenes taken from a trip to Syracuse, New York in 1971, where Don Mitchell and myself and our families decided to go and watch some good flying for the weekend. And that's the first time that we've seen really great multi-channel flying. And you must remember, in those days, that plane that you're looking at right now was a 10 controlled by a 10-channel orbit, two channels for each, two servos for each channel. So it was quite a chore in getting them up and getting them down. There was no such thing as no such thing as proportional flying. It was all bang, bang, left and right, up and down. What you're viewing now is a remnants of films that were taken in Syracuse, New York at the Mars Club, or the Arts Club, whatever they call themselves. Remember that to us, a plane, multi-channel airplane taking off like that was quite a thrill and quite an experience for us, which gave us the incentive to go further. There's only one person Ed Kazmersky is in the picture, Ed Keck is in the picture. The one from Cornwall related would be Bill Robertson, who is from St. Andrews, East Quebec, who used to come to our club periodically to do some flying with us. And in this film clip you're going to see there, he's got a black multi-channel airplane that is really, really something to watch. We enjoyed, we were tickled pink just to watch the tremendous flying and his ability to control it. And remember, we were single channel, day-to-day learning how to fly. That's a Demoiselle, another funny type of airplane. This is a high wing with very high dihedral. Back in Syracuse, you're now looking at the static display of all the aircraft at that time in 1971 that were on display and were flying, and they sure did a great job. The one person that I was talking about previously was Bill Robertson, and Bill is going to come up on the screen in a second. There's Bill Robertson with his RCAF type aircraft, and pterodactyl. This was a World War II training plane, biplane. I'm not sure what it was, but it was a very good flyer. It flew around really nice. And it did appear in the magazine, Fly Models, and it was quite a hit. Bill Robertson from St. Andrews, East Quebec, put on quite a flight display with his plane. We were so impressed that everybody wanted to go home and get into multi. Unfortunately, the cost was prohibitive, so very few of us ever did get into the multi aspect of flying. But if you take a look at this airplane, it's a beauty. Too bad we couldn't see airplanes like that this day and age. I'm not quite sure what the name of it was, but I know that he did do a spectacular job in flying it, and the building was superb, and it just answered perfectly. Remember, 10-channel orbit with bang-bang controls. Very, very difficult, no proportional. Whatever the smooth flying was done by him and his ability to control his thumbs. So it was quite impressive. We were impressed in 1970-some, believe me. You're watching great aerobatic flying taken in Syracuse, New York in 1971, 72, 73, somewhere in that summer, those summers, by Bill Robertson from St. Andrews, East Quebec. Remember, this was quite a thrill for anybody that was single channel flying. And it's something that sticks in your mind and you'll never forget it. The first flights that you've seen that were fully aerobatic and fantastic ability to control with the facilities that they had and the equipment that they had. And they've certainly come a long way since then. The transistor radio changed everything. That's a Demoiselle again. These take off. Now we're moving over to Messina, New York, the Model Airs field again, and you're going to see this was the Pony Express coming up. Now we're still seeing a little bit of the aerobatic airplane flying, and They're safely landed, and he's walking back to the pit area with his beautiful airplane. This is the biplane again, World War II, and Messina Airfield taken. That's Cliff Murpoff doing the Pony Express. I'm sure everybody's familiar with that. And Roger LaPointe is flying over with his large Telemaster. You'll see that coming now.